Do you have IBS? Well, in fact, it could be something called SIBO. IBS, of course, is when you're getting bloating or discomfort. You might have some wind. You might have diarrhea, constipation, or alternating between the two that creates huge discomfort in your life. Now, IBS has been around for many years and recognized as such, but in more recent years, there's a new phenomenon, which is known as SIBO. And this is considered to cause 2/3 of IBS symptoms. Now, what is SIBO? It stands for small intestinal bacteria overgrowth. It's when bacteria and other microbes that may normally reside in the colon have somehow managed to thrive and grow in the small intestines. The small intestines, of course, is where we should be digesting and then absorbing the nutrients from our food. So if plant food is arriving in the small intestines from the stomach, which has not yet been completely broken down, it gives the ability for certain bacteria and other microbes to feed off it. It starts to ferment this and it creates gases. Mostly we know these gases to be hydrogen, hydrogen sulfide and methane gases. Now, if you've got gas in your stomach, you might burp. And if you've got gas in your colon, you'll have wind. But if this gas is trapped in your small intestines, it's got nowhere to go until eventually it starts to dissipate. And this is what creates so much pain and discomfort there. It equally contributes to the problems that we know with the typical IBS symptoms of diarrhea and or constipation. In fact, it's the methane gas that causes the constipation, the hydrogen gas more likely to cause diarrhea, and the hydrogen sulfide gas most likely to cause a combination of the two.